After robbing a bank, a robber runs off at 8 miles per hour. 15 minutes later, the police officer on a bicycle leaves to catch the robber at 12 miles per hour. How long in hours does it take the police officer to catch up with the robber? So this problem involves the formula distance equals rate times time. So we're going to record all the information we can in this table, where this first row is going to be the information about the robber, and the second row will be the information about the police officer. So let's start with the rate. The rate of the robber is 8 miles per hour. So this is 8, and this column is in miles per hour. And the police officer on his bicycle is traveling at 12 miles per hour. Now these next two columns, the time and distance columns, are very important to set this up correctly. Notice the police officer leaves 15 minutes after the robber starts running, which gives the robber a 15-minute head start. But we also need to recognize that we need our time in terms of hours and not minutes. Well, 15 minutes is equal to 1/4 of an hour. So if we let the time the police officer is on his bicycle equal t, then the length of time that the robber will be running would be t plus 1/4 of an hour. And again, these units are in hours. And then notice how we also don't know the distance that both of them will travel, but since we want to know when the police officer is going to catch the robber, we know that these two distances are going to be the same. So if we call this d sub r for the distance the robber travels, and d sub p for the distance the police officer travels, and since we're trying to figure out when the police officer is going to catch up with the robber, that's going to occur when d sub r is equal to d sub p, or the distance that the robber and the police officer travel would be exactly the same. Well, we also know that d sub r is going to be equal to 8 times the quantity t plus 1/4, and d sub p is equal to 12 times t, or 12t, and now we have the equation that we need with one variable. So now we can solve this equation for t and answer the question. So we'll start by distributing. This will be 8t plus 8 times 1/4 is 2, equals 12t. Let's go ahead and subtract 8t on both sides of the equation. This would be 0. We'd have 2 equals, this will be 4t. Divide both sides by 4. And we have t equals 1/2. Notice that t is the time that the police officer is riding his bicycle. So it will take 1/2 of an hour for the police officer to catch the robber. Of course, half an hour is equal to 30 minutes, but they do ask for the time in hours. Okay, I hope this was helpful.